Hello everyone, I'm Shyam Pasari and welcome to ASIN Academy. Now as you can see from the title of this video, in this video we will learn how to find the highest power of a number p that divides x factorial. So without further ado, let's begin with our topic. Now before moving ahead, let's do a quick recap of what is a factorial. So factorial of a number is nothing but all the numbers from the number n up to the number 1. So if we have n factorial, then n factorial is equal to n into n minus 1 into all the numbers up to the number 1. Now if you have any doubt on the topic factorial, then I have made a separate video on this topic where I've explained all the topics in detail. So you should go watch that video first and then come back to this video. Now suppose I tell you to find out the highest power of 2 in the number 6 factorial. Now since 6 factorial is a small number, I can write it down as 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Now I can see that I have 1 2 over here, 2 2's over here because 4 is equal to 2 square, so I can write it as 2 square, and 1 2 over here as well because 6 is equal to 2 into 3, so I can write it as 2 to the power 1 into 3. So in total I have 1 plus 2 plus 1, that is equal to 4. So the highest power of 2 in 6 factorial is equal to 4. That was a pretty simple case. Now if I tell you to find out the highest power of 3 in 50 factorial, now this is not as simple as the previous one because 50 factorial is equal to 50 into 49 into all the numbers up to the number 1, and to write down all the powers of 3 in each numbers is not as easy as the previous one. So for this we will learn a very simple method by which we can calculate the power of any number in any large factorial. So suppose we have to find out the highest power of p in x factorial. So what we have to do is, we have to find out the sum of greatest integer value of x by p plus x by p square, and we will go all the way up to x by p to the power n. Now over here, p to the power n is greater than x. So by using this formula, we have to calculate the sum s and we will find out the highest power of p in x factorial. Now there is one very important fact to note, that is, this formula is only valid for prime numbers. So in this case, p should always be a prime number for this formula to be valid. We will also learn how to find out for non-prime numbers, but let us first check for the prime numbers. So for our first example, we have to find out the highest power of 3 in 50 factorial. So what we have to do is, we have to just put the value of 50 in place of x and the value of 3 in place of p, and we will get our answer. So we have to find out the greatest integer value of 50 by 3 plus greatest integer value of 50 by 9 plus greatest integer value of 50 by 27 plus greatest integer value of 50 by 81. Now you may have noticed that I have stopped at the value 81. This is because 3 to the power 4 is greater than 50, which is equal to 81. So we have went up to 81. Now the greatest integer value of 50 by 3 comes out to be 16, 50 by 9 comes out to be 5, 50 by 27 comes out to be 1, and lastly 50 by 81 comes out to be 0, and the sum of all these four values comes out to be 22. So the highest power of 3 in 50 factorial is 3 to the power 22. Now let's take an example for non-prime numbers as well. So for our second example, we have to find out the highest power of 6 in 80 factorial. So what we have to do for non-prime cases is that first we have to prime factorize the number, in this case which is 2 into 3, and then we have to take the highest prime, in this case which is 3, and we have to find out the highest power of the highest prime in that case. So for finding out the highest power of 6 in 80 factorial is equivalent to finding out of highest power of 3 in 80 factorial. So the highest power of 6 in 80 factorial is equal to 80 by 3 plus 80 by 9 plus 80 by 27 and lastly 80 by 81. Now we have went up to 81 because 81 is greater than 80. So we have to find out the sum of this value, and that will give the highest power of 6 in 80 factorial. So the greatest integer value of 80 by 3 is 26. Then the greatest integer value of 80 by 9 is 8. And the greatest integer value of 80 by 27 is 2. And lastly, the greatest integer value of 80 by 81 is 0. So the sum of these four values comes out to be 36. So the highest power of 6 in 80 factorial is equal to 6 to the power 36. So let's solve our third example. So for this case, we have to find out the highest power of 42 in 100 factorial. Now we can clearly see that 42 is not a prime number. So first we'll prime factorize 42, which comes out to be 2 into 3 into 7. Now, going according to the formula, we have to take the highest prime in it, which is 7. So we have to find out the highest power of 7 in 100 factorial. Now the highest power of 7 in 100 factorial is equal to the greatest integer value of 100 divided by 7 plus the greatest integer value of 100 divided by 49, which is 7 squared, plus the greatest integer value of 100 divided by 7 cubed, which is equal to 343. Now in this case also, we have went up to 343 because 343 is greater than 100. Now the greatest integer value of 100 by 7 comes out to be 14, and the greatest integer value of 100 by 49 comes out to be 2, and the greatest integer value of 100 by 343 comes out to be 0. So the final answer is equal to 14 plus 2 plus 0, which is equal to 16. So the highest power of 42 in 100 factorial is equal to 16.
That's all for this video, and I hope that you understood all the topics covered in this video. And if you have any doubt, then you can post your doubts down in the comment section, or you can send your doubts to us to our channel's official Instagram or Facebook page, and we will surely solve your doubt as soon as possible. Or you can go to the official website of ASN Academy and you can send your doubts to us from there, and all the links are provided down in the description. And if you did like the video, then please hit the like button and subscribe to the channel ASN Academy. Oh,